tougher on Russia than Donald Trump. And I'll tell you, they were so bad. They took over the submarine port. You remember that very well. During your term, during you and Barack Obama, they took over a big part of what should have been Ukraine. You handed it to them. But you were getting a lot of money from Russia. They were paying you a lot of money, and they probably still are. But now, with what came out today, it's even worse. All of the emails, the horrible emails of the kind of money that you were raking in, you and your family. And, Joe, you were vice president when some of this was happening, and it should have never happened. And I think you owe an explanation to the American people. Why is it? Somebody just had a news conference a little while ago who was essentially supposed to work with you and your family, but what he said was damning. And regardless of me, I think you have to clean it up and talk to the American people. Maybe you can do it right now.
Vice President Biden, you may respond. 30 seconds. And then I want to follow up on the election security.
I have not taken a penny from any.
And so you can think about that with regards to this poem. Invocation of one in despair. So, a god has snatched from me all my all. In the curse and rack of destiny, all his worlds are gone beyond recall. Nothing but revenge is left to me. On myself, revenge I'll proudly wreak. On that being, that enthroned Lord, make my strength a patchwork of what's weak. Leave my better self without reward. I shall build my throne high overhead. Cold, tremendous shall its summit be. For its bulwark, superstitious dread. For its martial, blackest agony. Who looks upon it with a healthy eye shall turn back, struck deathly pale and dumb, clutched by blind and chilled mortality. May his happiness prepare its tomb. And the Almighty's lightning shall rebound from that massive iron giant. If he brings my walls and towers down, eternity shall raise them up, defiant. It knows to be true and correct. And that is how people think. And it isn't obvious that why we think that way. That this is part of the reason that it seems to me so obvious that we have a religious instinct, because I can't think of what else you would possibly call that other than a religious instinct. You know, Nietzsche, when he proclaimed the death of God, which by the way was no triumphant proclamation, because he also mentioned that we would never find enough water to wash away the blood, which was his what would you call it, prognostication for the 20th century, and a very accurate one at that. He believed that we would, in some sense, have to become as gods in ourselves in order to replace what we had lost. He thought that the collapse of the Judeo-Christian structure would be absolutely catastrophic for the West, and I believe that he was correct, and that the way out of that would be that we'd have to create our own values. We'd have to take the place of what was once, let's say, externalized and divine onto ourselves. And, you know, it's a hell of a theory. And Nietzsche is not an easy person to criticize, because you have to do a lot of reading before you find someone who's one-tenth as smart as Nietzsche. He has this funny line about his books. It's really quite comical. He said, takes most writers a whole book to write what I can write in a sentence. Then he said, no, they can't even manage it in a book. And that's actually true. I mean, if you read Nietzsche, Beyond Good and Evil, for example, you see that his thought is so powerful that it's really a kind of...